So today's recipe is this beautiful, delicious milk cream. So stay tuned to Akshata's recipes.
Hi everyone, and welcome to Akshata's recipes. Thank you so much for stopping by. See loads and loads of Christmas recipes coming up on my channel. Most of my recipes are handed down to me by my mom in her Christmas recipe book. Let's get started with today's recipe.
So let's get started with the recipe. Now here I've taken a heavy bottomed pan and I'm going to be heating 1 liter of milk. Here I have measured 450 grams of sugar. We can transfer this to a bowl. Now we have to boil the milk till it reduces to half on a low to medium flame. We're going to use a wooden spoon with a long handle. Now I'm going to be measuring 100 grams of cashew nuts. We're going to also be using this kind of a milk cream rubber mold. This is the silicone mold, but this is the authentic, the real milk cream mold. Now we're going to grind this cashew nut to a powder using the blitz function. Otherwise, you will get a paste. Now you can transfer this to another bowl. Now our milk has started to boil, so we're going to stir a bit, scraping the edges of the pan. Otherwise, it gets sticky and you get a very different kind of burnt milk smell. So you need to continuously stir once the milk starts to boil. And we're going to boil this till it reduces to about half of its quantity. That takes about roughly 10 minutes. Now this recipe does require a lot of patience and it requires a lot of elbow grease or, you know, really working out your hands. Now I've added the sugar after my milk has reduced to half and we are going to stir till all of the milk dissolves. Now once all the milk dissolves, we're going to add the cashew nut powder. So this is just a 3-ingredient recipe. And now all we have to do is just keep stirring on a low to medium flame with our wooden spoon. Now take a wooden spoon with a long handle. The reason being that first of all, the heat is quite a bit. So, you know, your hand shouldn't get really, you know, hot and, you know, with the steam and the heat coming out, you should keep yourself safe. Also, the heavy bottom pan is being used because it doesn't move because there's a lot of stirring involved. If you use a lightweight vessel, it might topple, it might turn around, you know, it might just keep on moving, which is quite a bother. So use a heavy bottom pan and a wooden spoon with a long handle. And all you have to do is just keep stirring on a low to medium flame. Now this entire process of stirring till I found that my mixture was completely ready took me exactly 35 minutes in total. I had put a timer on my phone and I can know that it was exactly 35 minutes of continuous stirring. And once your mixture starts to thicken, it will be a real fast procedure. Then it will just start thickening very, very quickly. It is just the initial stage that it takes some time for everything to get, you know, to that particular stage. So you can take the help of some of your family members, friends in the stirring process, but the end result is really worth it. And you'll be so happy that you have made it yourself. And it's really, really so satisfying. So we're going to continuously stir. Now, what I like to do, you know, to just kill the time is listen to my favorite podcast or some lovely music or just chat with your family. And, you know, it happens so fast that you won't even realize that it's already been like 35 minutes. So keep yourself occupied. And don't forget to stir, because if you stop stirring, it might just, get a little bit on the, it might get a little on that burnt flavor. Now, if you want to see that your mixture is ready, just take a bowl of water and drop around 1/4 teaspoon. And if you're able to form a smooth ball easily, that means your mixture is ready. Now, I just like to stir for another 2 minutes. And then I'm going to turn off the flame, and we're going to transfer this mixture onto a steel plate or a glass plate, because that way it cools down faster. Now you can even just stir it a bit and let it cool completely. Don't be in a hurry to handle it because it's really, really hot. Now once it is completely cool, just grease your hands with some ghee or some butter and just knead this to a very smooth dough, and then just make little balls and then insert them into the mold. Now, this kind of a mold is the ideal mold to be used for milk cream. It's a rubber mold and it's easily available. Now, I got mine from Crawford Market. As many of you who have been regularly watching all my videos and my shopping hauls and all know that I love to shop at Crawford because you get everything under one roof and pretty reasonable too. Now, I got this mold for just ₹250, but it's worth it because it's a lifelong investment. Every Christmas, I'm going to be making milk cream for sure, more than once. And so, it's really worth it. Now, you get the silicone molds. They're just ₹50, but I've used them in my past two milk cream recipes, but I was just not completely satisfied because I know this is the ideal mold and I was looking for it for the past 2 years and I couldn't find it anywhere. So I was so happy this time that I got the exact milk cream mold. And just demold them, and they have such pretty shell shapes, all little different shell shapes. And if any of your shapes don't really come out properly, just make them into a ball again and just insert them into the mold again and it'll be perfect. I remember my mom used to make, these milk cream in this shell thing, and it was just divine. So I got exactly 106 milk creams from these measurements of all the ingredients that I used. So I hope you like today's recipe. It's so quick and it's so satisfying and it's so easy to make. So I hope you'll try out this recipe. Actually, this is the perfect recipe. You will not go wrong. So don't be afraid. I know the stirring does take a lot of effort, but it's worth it in the end. So let me hear from all of you what you think of this recipe. And once you all try it out, I want to know how you and your family and friends liked it. So leave your comments down below. Also, don't forget to go and check out my channel. I've got loads and loads and loads of Christmas recipes. I will be leaving the link to each and every recipe that I've put up so far in my description box as well as the comment box. So just click the link. It will take you there. Thank you so much for watching. Loads of recipes on my channel, so go and check them out. I will leave a link of all my recipes that I've put up for the past 2 years, for the past two Christmases. You'll find all the links in my description box below. So I hope you enjoyed today's recipe and I hope you will give it a try. Do let me know in the comments box below what you thought of today's recipe. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up by hitting the thumbs up icon. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Do share my recipes with family and friends. And be sure to go and check out Akshata's recipes. I have loads and loads of recipes. Thank you so much for watching and I'll catch you in my next video. Take care. Bye. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Making spirits bright.
fortune seemed hidden.